Hey there guys, I'm NadirBaz, and in this tutorial I'll be showing you how you can enable auto deploy GitLab using GitLab CI. So what we want to do in this tutorial is when you push code to your GitLab repo, it should get built and deployed to your web server. Whether it's a Vue.js app, Angular or React app, or either a Laravel app or any kind of application. If it's a Node.js app, you can install all the dependencies and then deploy it. If this is a Vue.js or a front-end framework app, you can install dependencies as well as build it and then deploy it. If this is a Laravel app, you can migrate any new migrations after deploying it. So let's get started. We can divide this into three steps. The first is going to be installing a GitLab runner. GitLab runners are services that sit on your server, on your web server, where you want to deploy your code. They are typically Linux servers, so you will install this runner onto your web server. Whenever there's a push made to the repository, some code is pushed, GitLab will automatically trigger a pipeline. And a pipeline can contain a lot of jobs, and to run those jobs is the job of this runner. Let's get started and install it. GitLab docs, which tells us how we can install GitLab runner. Binaries are available for Windows, Mac OS, and Linux. For demonstration, I'll be using Linux server. I'll not be using an actual Linux server, but I'll be using a virtual machine, which will work fine. This is a terminal. Okay, so we scroll down here and there's a list of commands that we want to run if we want to install the GitLab runner. First command being this. Let's copy that and paste that in here. Okay, this is what this command did is it used the curl library to download a binary from this URL to this directory, user local bin GitLab runner. Now what we need to do is make this binary executable so we can install it. Let's run this command. The next command is to create a GitLab CI user, or in other words, to create a Linux user, a standard Linux user dedicated to running jobs on the runner. So basically the jobs that runner will run on your web server will use this user and not the root user. I already have done this, so I won't do it. You can do it for sure. The next is actually installing that binary we just downloaded, and we're telling it to user should be GitLab. It should use the GitLab runner user to run its jobs. You can also specify any other user here, root, such as root here, but that is not recommended. So let's install it. It failed to install because I already have it. Now we will start it, and it's already running. Step two is to register the GitLab runner on GitLab. So I have got this repository. It contains a Vue.js app, which I just cloned from a GitHub repo. Okay, so we've got the app. What we need to do is we got the repository emit, and we needed to register a GitLab runner on this repository. The runner we just installed here, we need to register that runner into this repository. We go to settings and CI/CD. We go into the runner section, and then we first disable shared runners because now I've got a dedicated runner. We don't need shared runners. Then we need to copy this token, and then we need to go back to our server and actually run register sudo gitlab runner register https gitlab.com token. Some description can be dedicated runner. Make sure the tags are empty. Just hit enter. and write shell here because we are using shell as the executor of the commands that will be building and installing dependencies. We don't need Docker here. So the runner is registered. Let's see. Let's verify that by reloading this page and see if it is, you can see here. And you can see caution sign before it. That basically means hasn't been connected yet. That's because it hasn't got a job yet. It will get a job once we push some changes with a gitlab-ci.yml file included in the root directory of our project. So now we'll be creating a gitlab-ci.yml file. What this file does is it contains all the commands that the runner needs to execute to successfully build an application and install any dependencies. Okay, so first we gotta define stages, and you can have multiple stages with any names. I will, for simplicity, have this deploy stage. You can have build, test, and deploy. And in the script section, we'll write the commands that need to be running. So if this is a Vue.js app, firstly, we need to install all the dependencies. Secondly, we need to build the app. Building a Vue app, you get a dist folder here in the root directory, which you want to deploy. So what I'll do is I'll grab every content of that dist folder and put in my Apache root directory, where all gets served. If I go into the server and go into Mozilla Firefox, you can see this page, Apache Ubuntu default page, and this is the IP address to that server. So we'll be pushing code to GitLab, and the runner will build the app, and this content, as you can see here, will change into that Vue app that you just saw here. So to do that, after building, we need to copy recursively dists, everything that's inside this folder, into var www. On example.com. You need to specify your own path here. Grab everything from this, put it here in example.com HTML. But we can make another check here that this, by the way, we're using bash syntax here. So we can do an if statement. This is basically the branch name that is being pushed. If it is the master branch, then only then we want to actually deploy the code, right? Otherwise, we don't. Make sure to end the if statement here. Let's save this file and commit it and push it to GitLab. Once you have pushed, you need to go to, however, CI/CD and pipelines. You can see here a job, which is in pending state because it hasn't been picked up by the runner, which is sitting on this server. We just need to wait. Also, you can see that deploy job is pending. A pipeline can have multiple jobs. Any stage here is basically a job. And a pipeline can have one or more jobs in a sequence. They will run in a sequence based on how they were defined, the order they were defined. As you can see now, it is running and the deploy is running. You can actually click on that job to see its log. You can see here, first, it initialized a Git repository. Then it ran npm install. As you can see that the installer ran and then build ran, but it got an error at this expression. It requires a semicolon here and then a then here. So I'll just quickly push. Our new job is running with the fix I just made in the syntax. And as you can see here, the job has succeeded. And now if we go to our machine, here you can see the same app built and deployed to that server. So this is how you add auto deploy to GitLab. You can also, there are a bunch of these kind of variables that you can play with. You can check that out at GitLab. Thank you for watching the video.